Today we will start surface tension. Suppose this is a free liquid surface below which there is a liquid and above which there is a vapor. It is a vapor, liquid, and this is the interface. Now suppose we take a molecule A and molecule B. Molecule A is surrounded by liquid in all the sides, so there will be a net resultant force which will be equal to zero. But for molecule B, as it is surrounded by liquid only below free liquid surface, so there will be a net resultant force. Due to net resultant force, there will be a tensile force. This tensile force is the surface tension. It is a line force. Its value equal to force per unit rent. It is denoted by sigma. It is an unbalanced cohesive force. What is a cohesive force? Cohesive force is force of attraction between same molecule. And adhesive force is a force of attraction between a different molecule. So here we have a same molecule, so surface tension is due to cohesive force. At critical point. What is a critical point? Suppose this is a T by S diagram. This is our critical point. Here liquid vapor interface vanish. So our sigma will be equal to zero. At critical point, surface tension will be equal to zero. Now three important cases. First one is pressure inside a liquid block. We have to find the SX pressure inside a liquid block. Suppose this is a liquid block. Now the cross section area. Now the net pressure will be P, and the surface, since it is a line force, it will be around the circumference. Sigma. So at equilibrium, the pressure force will be equal to force due to surface tension. Now force due to pressure. Suppose P is our pressure. Then force it will be equal to P into area. P into pi by 4 d square. Now surface tension will be equal to sigma into circumference. Sigma into pi d. So P will be equal to 4 sigma by D. Now the second case. We will have a bubble, soap. Now when we see the cross section area of so bubble, it will be like this. There will be two surfaces. Suppose the thickness between the surface is very less, so we ignore it. Since it will have a two So the value of sigma will be around the line, we will have a sigma and our pressure will be P. So F of P will be equal to F of S. F of P will be equal to P into pi by 4 D square will be equal to sigma into pi d into we have two surfaces. In weaker dough we have only one surface, but in soap bubble we have two surfaces, so into 2. By solving we get P will be equal to x 8 sigma by d. And the third case is liquid jet. Suppose this is our liquid jet. Now seeing a cross section view, so in the sigma value surface tension is always around the line, because it is a line force. As shown earlier, it is a line force. This will be our sigma and the value of P. Suppose D is the diameter, L is the length, so it will be D, it will be L. Now FP equal to FS, force due to pressure will be equal to P into area. Area will be equal to L into D, area of rectangle. So since it is a rectangular surface. Now due to surface tension, which will be equal to sigma into L plus L, 2L. By solving, P will be equal to 2 sigma by D. So these are the three important cases. So let's revise. Surface tension, it is a line force. It is at the interface between a liquid surface and a vapor surface. Since at critical point there is no interface between liquid and vapor surface, so our surface tension will be equal to zero. It is an unbalanced cohesive force. Cohesive force is a force of attraction between same molecule. Now liquid dwarf. Liquid dwarf we have only one surface, so by equilibrium force due to pressure will be force due to surface tension. Force due to pressure will be P into pi by 4 d square, so area will be pi by 4 d square equal to force due to surface tension. Sigma into surface tension is always around the line, because it is a line force. This will be our line. Pi into D around the circumference. P will be equal to 4 sigma by D. In case of soap bubble, we have two surfaces. First one will be this and second one will be this. We have ignored the thickness. So our pressure force equal to surface tension force. P into pi by 4 D square equal to sigma into pi D we had done twice because we have two surfaces. And for EquiJet, f of p equal to f of x, this is a cross section area, p into l into d equal to 2, sigma into 2l, because we have surface tension around these lines. So p will be equal to 2 sigma by d. Thank you.